I was, on my way to sunny front of Spain. You remember that time? Yeah. Mark that queen in the town full stress. I've been like pushing my bike the past for hours. I was tired and sweaty. My mood was sour. Along comes this owner, Foxy Bus. Remember that time, eh? On the television.
No.
Gives me a tow up the Tierkloof Pass, put his foot down, soon reached the top, and I rang my bell for the bus to stop. But did we ever tell you about what happened afterwards? Huh? I mean, did they're the gun, they make the TV program, and they don't tell you about what happened afterwards, because there I was, Mensa, singing and grinning and like windgat skidding around every corner. When suddenly my tires flew over the wires of Umgert's new gasometer and excree, oh, donor. And I hoed on anchors, but it was all in vain, because my brake cable snapped and off came my chain. And I hurtled down the Tierkloof Pass. Mensa, I'm going like a Boeing, my hou net vas, eh? My heart is opgebogge and I lose one of my fillies, and the road is bumping and my gat is stumping and my derms are feeling like Moya's jelly. And as die kant toe and as die kant toe and on a level stress. And little, mensa, did I know about the rapport fietstoer bicycle race. Yeah, no, this is true. See, because the ouds had come from far and wide to compete in this groot bloody bicycle ride. I mean, there were ouds like a Erkies Poseidon out. Remember him? I used to call him Pierre before he took up cycling. And this is true. And there was a Spiro de Vries, man. Spiro de Vries. And there was a team from Italy and a couple of Portuguese. And the ouds had all started out early that morning on this last leg of the race. You see, that wound up. Through the Tierkloof Pass and ended daaronder in full stress. And the ouds were sweating. They were sweating and they were standing on their pedals. Dreaming of the cups and the prizes and the silver medals. When suddenly, mensa, I come round the corner and I find these ouds in my way. Ek skree net, pas op, mensa! En ek vlieg verby. Well, I tell you, it looked like our Erkies was riding a trike, eh? As I overtook him on my duckwheel bike. But then I'm afraid I ran out of luck. Because as I left the mountains, disaster struck. Because in my way, mensa, was Oom Jannie Dreyer. Now, Oom Jannie, as you might know, is the town's nachtwaarrijer. You know what that is? Night swirl card. But I couldn't swerve, I couldn't stop, and I swear I saw Oom Jannie's eyeballs pop as I hit that cart and my head got stuck right up to my shoulders in his heap of muck. But my poor old bicycle, with its two fat tires, mensa, it did this bola makisi over the telephone wires, and it smashed and it crashed and it stopped dead in its tracks against the four steel girders of a wind pump called Climax. Have you never heard of a pump that ended in a climax? All of us. No, you must go out into the country. There's all sorts of things happening out there. Now I tell you, I felt like crying. I felt like crying when I saw that crumpled old plaasfiets of mine. And then suddenly up comes this owner, a bucky, jumps out, says, "Yes, sir, David, you know I'm a sucky." And he loads up my bicycle and drives away in a hurry and he says, "Just you wait there, pal, and don't you worry." And when he came back, well, that's when I caught a groot skrik. I said, "Mommy, liewe hemel, sucky, is jy daar by dik?" Because they turned that bike of mine, no word of a lie, from an opgebogde plaasfiets into a GTI. I mean, it had these lekker mag wheels, eh? With like drop handlebars. And it had two rearview mirrors, just like a car's. And it had lights and goeders and an orange dashboard fluff, eh? And I said, "Oh, Sakkie man, how can I thank you enough, you know?" And I said, "Sakkie man," he puffed out his chest, eh? And he pulled his maag in. And he said, "Oh, David, isn't that what you'd expect from Volkswagen?"